This is my custom keyboard that I designed and built from scratch, and in this video I will show you the whole process of building it. I already have this keyboard for video editing, but I have never used half of these keys and the shortcuts can be customized. So how hard can it be to design your own keyboard? A keyboard has a lot of different parts, each with many types and options. There is the PCB, case, plate, switches, keycaps, rotary encoders, different features like backlight, RGB lighting, displays, vibration motors, and so on. And on top of that is the firmware, the driver on your computer, and software to customize the shortcuts. It may look complicated, but it's not. Let's start from the PCB. I drew the schematic and routed the PCB in a free online software called EasyEDA. The PCB has 4 layers with a Raspberry Pi RP2040 microcontroller soldered directly onto the board. I wanted the keyboard to be highly customizable, so the key switches are hot swappable, meaning you can replace them anytime without any soldering. When a switch is pressed, we can detect either a low or high signal, 0 or 3.3 volts, on a specific microcontroller pin. But it's not that simple. This microcontroller only has 30 pins that can be used, and this keyboard has 50 switches plus extra encoders. To connect more switches than the number of pins on our microcontroller, a key matrix system is used. The switches are organized into rows and columns, and software is needed to recognize which of the keys are pressed. This is done by a process called matrix scanning. We detect which row and which column are connected together. If your keyboard has a very unique layout, you still need to decide which keys belong in which row and column. My keyboard's layout looked like this. Based on this layout, I created a schematic that contains the microcontroller, the matrix with all the switches, RGB LEDs under each key, and rotary encoders, which are usually used for adjusting volume, but you can use them for whatever you like. I also place a motor for haptic feedback, metal plate holders, stabilizers, and some other necessary parts like level shifter, power, user LEDs, flash memory, and so on. I have also designed a smaller, simpler version of this keyboard, and if you want, I will create a full step-by-step tutorial about how you can build your own keyboard from scratch, where I will explain everything in detail. You will learn how to draw the schematic and do PCB layout by yourself. If it sounds interesting, please let me know in the comments. Okay, now let's have a look at the PCB. We have to draw the physical connections on the real board. Here, every millimeter and all the positions are very important. After designing the PCB, I uploaded all the information to JLC PCB, who also sponsored this video. I use JLC PCB as ordering from their website is very simple, affordable for all professionals and also for hobbies, and their delivery time is quick. I really like that everyone who is following my tutorials can get their own real boards through JLC PCB. After ordering the board, less than 2 weeks later this arrived. All the components are already fitted except the encoders that I bought separately and had to solder down. I tested it, measured the signals, and everything works as it should. Well done, Robert. Next, I needed a custom box for my new keyboard, so I designed a simple case in Fusion 360 software and 3D printed it. You can do this at home using your 3D printer and it's perfectly fine, but for the final version I used the JLC 3DP website because 3D printed parts from industrial printers look much nicer and they can polish the surface to make it more glossy. Also, they use SLA printers, so the layers are not as visible as if I use my FDM 3D printer. The next important step in a keyboard build is choosing a mounting style. The mounting style defines how the PCB, the keys, and the plate are secured within a keyboard housing. Some mountings are rigid, some are more flexible, and they affect the sound and the overall feel of the keyboard. For this version, I chose the integrated mounting style because it is the quickest and simplest solution, and of course that also means that the overall build price is lower. However, This is something that I would like to improve, and for the final version of my keyboard, I'm planning to add some kind of a metal plate. Okay, now the most important thing, the part that defines the sound and the feel, the switches. There are so many different types of switches, and I spent some time trying to figure out which of them to use. I chose Cherry MX Red linear switches. They come pre-lubricated, they are easy to press, and they are quiet. And since I made the keyboard hot swappable, I can always find other good switches and easily change them. Along with the switches, we have 6 encoders that I use during video editing to move the playing head or zoom in, zoom out. But basically, these are just knobs you can spin. I spend a lot of time looking for good encoders with a smooth feel, but they are actually very hard to find. If you know any good ones, please leave recommendations in the comments. I tried buying knobs for the encoders, but eventually I decided to create my own and 3D print them. If anyone is interested, the files can be downloaded on my Thingiverse. Probably the most customizable part of the keyboard are the keycaps. There are many different types and designs. Flat, small, big, raised, transparent. You can order keycaps or you can 3D print your own. I decided to design and 3D print my own keycaps. I came up with a solution that allows the text to be changed. This is the design. A simple keycap with a place to store a piece of paper covered by a removable lid made from a transparent material. I'm thinking of making the transparent lids from laser cut plexiglass to make them prettier. For the final version, after I decide on the list of macros and functions, I will probably order a set of nice keycaps with custom text. Okay, now the most important thing is to convince my computer that this is a real keyboard. We need a special firmware for the microcontroller. For this, I use QMK, which is an open source firmware for all sorts of input devices including keyboards. You define your keyboard, router encoder functions, features and properties, and then flash it. To flash the firmware on my keyboard, I don't need any additional software since I'm using RP2040. Just build the firmware to a UF2 file, copy to RP2040, and that's it. To test our keyboard, we can just open Notepad or we can directly read the messages sent over USB. You can stop here and it would be just fine. But if you wanted to change the macros or shortcuts, you would have to change the firmware and copy it again and again. There is a much easier way to update shortcuts. It can be done directly from browser by using this VIA application. To see the keyboard in VIA, we need to create and export the keyboard layout. It can be done in a simple editor that looks something like this. It's really easy. Then, once we update the firmware to make it compatible with VIA, we can go to the VIA website and make changes on our keyboard online without installing anything. We can change mapping, macros, lighting, whatever is supported. This helps a lot. Everything is ready, so let me show you the keyboard in action. I will open DaVinci Resolve and I can easily move the playhead, zoom in, zoom out, cut a video or delete it. And if I need a new shortcut, in VIA software I will find the key and update it. There also are some extra features, for example I can change the color of LEDs or animation presets. That's it! Don't forget to let me know if you want to see a full step-by-step tutorial about how to design and build your own keyboard. And if you want to learn more about schematic design or PCB layout, check out our other videos and courses at fedevel.com. Links are in description. Thank you for watching and see you next time. Bye!